G'day guys, Tales20 here, and welcome back to another episode of Springfield. So when I record episodes for my channel, I like to have a very clear idea of exactly what I'm going to be building and how each episode is going to take shape. For this episode, I thought I was going to be building Bumtown, and I knew where I was going to build it, and then I was going to do this whole pre-build that you can see me doing right now. But when I got to Bumtown, I realized that it was just not going to work in that location. So it just threw the entire episode off. So this episode might feel a little bit different to the others, a little bit more thrown together, and we work on some different things. That's because that's exactly what happened. I had to change what I was going to be building halfway through the episode. So it might feel a little bit different to others. And that's the reason why, and I'll explain why Bumtown didn't work in that area when we get to it. But first, we are just finishing off this area that we were working in last week. I did mention that I wanted to do some more museums and arts galleries and like bigger buildings around this waterfront, or around this river, because they sort of felt a little bit right for this area. And I knew that I had to place a whole bunch of these museums and galleries and these larger buildings because they feature so heavily in The Simpsons that we did need a couple of them. They're very bit more generic looking. I actually made them from finding some of the better assets from the university's DLC, and they're really great looking buildings. They make fantastic larger buildings for like art galleries and museums and science centers. And typically you can't use them because you can only place them within a campus, but if you use procedural objects to change them to a procedural object, then you can place them anywhere you like in the city. And you guys know the way I like to play City Skylines. I don't really like to just place random props and buildings purely just because I think that's where they should go. I like there to be functionality behind my city. I like there to be traffic, I like there to be problems and things I need to solve, and I like to know that every single building in my city has some sort of purpose. So, to make sure that these guys still act like museums and art galleries, I found these really great buildings on the workshop. These are little cubes that there's a whole bunch of them, and they all basically serve as either some sort of service or a building from the game. So some of them are stadiums and some of them are schools, and they're just these little cubes. And you can place them within your other buildings so that they have that functionality. And I'll really love that, because that way you can use these buildings and then place these cubes inside them and they still function exactly how you want them to. And I really love that. I think that's such a fun idea. I got that from CityWalk CityWall. He got me onto those buildings, and it's something I'm going to be doing a lot more of. So we now have a whole bunch of museums and art galleries and science centers. And now we have the Springfield Tar Pit, which is something that has been requested for quite a while. But I have been holding off building it because I did know I wanted to place it around here, closer to the downtown, but in some sort of parkland. So it's kind of close to the Jebediah Springfield Park. And yeah, it just seems like to be a pretty decent and realistic place for a tar pit, which is a pretty random place. But of course, this is where Stampy comes and saves Homer's life after he tries to get himself out of the tar pit using his face.
First, I'll just reach in and pull my legs out. Now I'll pull my arms out with my face.
But as you can see, this whole area is called the Theatre District. So I've actually gone through and named all of my areas within Springfield based on this really great fan-made Simpsons wiki page, which I've mentioned quite a lot, but it's just been so super helpful to get ideas and information about where things should go. And yeah, I've gone through and just named all my districts. So this is a theatre district. There's not a huge amount known about this area, but there is definitely a place called the Theatre District. So I knew that this was going to be more the, you know, kind of random locations that just had to make sure it existed, place down a couple of things around here, and that's about it. But I don't really know what else would be around the Theatre District. I thought, you know, a couple of cinemas potentially. There are some bigger buildings that you'd sort of imagine would be theatres. And then I thought that this might be a good spot for the Big T Cinema, which I did mention I was going to place down in the last episode, but here it is. one of those builds that unfortunately just took longer than I originally imagined. The problem with this series is that I can just quickly make the Big T theater. It's really easy. It's just a Big T on a building that says Big T theater. And unfortunately, this takes an hour and a half or something to put together, to like scroll through, find the assets, realize that I need to get some more assets from the workshop, leave the game, load the game back up. It's just such a trial and error thing that happens, and at the end of it, I only make one building, and it just takes so long, and it's just one of those things. But it's so necessary, because I definitely needed to place down this building, and I couldn't, you know, there was no other way of doing it. I had to place it down like this. So we're going to have like a break next week. I'm going to get into Marble Mountain, because I know a lot of you guys are really, really keen to see Marble Mountain. We started something really fun in Marble Mountain, and I've kind of just only done that slowly because it's been holidays. I've been doing a couple of other things, and I just know that a whole bunch of you guys are hanging out for some Marble Mountain episodes. So we're going to be focusing on Marble Mountain for the next few weeks, but there'll be still stuff happening in Springfield behind the scenes when I get a little bit more ahead and figure out how things are going to start taking shape. We have a little less pressure for releasing weekly episodes. Now we're starting to work around the train line. This is where the trouble started to become apparent about Bombtown, but yeah, I'll get to that just shortly. But I just want to do a bit of detail around here. This train line goes across the river, goes towards Hickton, which is the farming town of... Well, actually, it's still attached to Springfield, but it's the farming region of Springfield. And then it goes out into the greater region, Ogdenville and New Havenbrook. But yeah, did need to detail this up a little bit and just trying to figure out how this is going to look, because by default, it's just grass next to the train line. I always feel like that's a little bit strange, having like a manicured grass land around here, unless it's some sort of park, then sure, but it's just sort of dead space. You know, it's either industrial or it's pretty unusable area. And I thought, okay, well, maybe some of this area would be just more of this brownish ground, which I thought would be a little bit more realistic than just having grass. So I just put a couple of lines of trees around the houses, and then closer to where Theatre District is, because there is, you know, it's slightly more commercial and industrial around here. I thought, okay, well, maybe instead we could have some parking lots. And I thought that was a little bit more of a realistic touch. Okay, so here is where I want a Bumtown to go, and this is a really great location, close to the downtown, close to a more commercial area, but unfortunately, this doesn't work for Bumtown because the train line surrounds this whole area, and I needed a train line to go through the middle of Bumtown, or at least dividing Bumtown from Theatre District, so that we could have this other side of the track type of situation going, where you'd cross the line and all of a sudden it's Bumtown and it's pretty run down. Unfortunately, there was no way of getting a train line that did that, because it was already pretty tight where the train line was, and there was a train station pretty close to this area, which made it really hard to put another junction, and there was no reason for the train line to go through this area, so it had to sort of make some sort of sense. So I had to scrap that idea, which was like just an absolute annoyance, because I already had it in my mind where this is going to go. So I do know where I'm going to put Bumtown now, and we'll have to do that in the next episode. But for this area, I thought we did need to update it a bit. I didn't want it just be these houses right next to the downtown. I felt like we needed to have some sort of transition. So I thought we did need a couple of bigger buildings. So still following the same thing that I was doing earlier on in this episode, grabbing a couple of university buildings that just fits really nicely in areas like this. I needed this Screaming Monkey medical facility somewhere in Springfield. So I placed it here, and this building just works really nicely for that. And the building. So you saw that I selected a couple of the houses around here, and I just needed to change them up, because originally when I first started this series, we were going to be using all custom assets, and I was going to use this type of houses that, I mean, if you recall me talking about, so it was going to look in a particular way, but because we are using so many custom Simpsons buildings, which are more cartoony than realistic ones that you can find from the workshop, I did need to change them up. So I had to make this transition a little bit better and use a couple more vanilla buildings that fit a little bit more of a Simpsons vibe than some of the other ones from the workshop. And because this is so close to the downtown, I figured this is a more historical and older looking neighborhood, and I thought this would be a really good spot for the Maison Derrière, which is of course the burlesque house from The Simpsons, and I definitely needed to be placing this thing down because it's something that's been very long requested, and it's such a prominent landmark of Springfield. Of course, Marge does demolish it by accident, but I'm sure it's rebuilt. This is the version that we got going on here. But yes, this is such a great looking building. This is being kindly made by Pyvane 96. You can grab it from the Steam Workshop. It's been up there for quite a while now, since December 16th. So big thanks to you. Thank you very much for making it. And I have just changed it a little bit, just adding a little bit more details based on what I can see from some pictures. What I first did was I PO'd it so that I could remove some of the hedges around here, and I added in my own custom fence and some this entranceway too, which is just this decal. There's like a turning circle that's around here. Maybe a vehicle could do a turn around here, but I don't know if it probably could. It's probably a little bit too tight for that. But just some hedges around, and I thought that this would be a pretty secluded and, you know, pretty, it kind of looks like an overgrown house as well. Like, there's a lot of bushes and trees around, so I figured we should probably include that. And something else that is just like a great little feature that I just didn't, you know, this just happens. This just seems to happen quite a lot within the series. But it is very clear that the boys are flying a model aeroplane in Springfield Park, or in Jebediah Springfield Park, and then the plane lands on the roof, and it's like opposite the park, which is just so happens to be where I have placed this down. It's opposite Jebediah Springfield Park. I mean, how the hell did I manage to do that? It's just such a great little thing that just so happens, and I'm very lucky about that. But just to finish off this area, I figured because we do have the Maison Derrière here, and it's a pretty big building, it's a bit of a mansion, I figured we did need a couple more mansions or big Victorian buildings around here, so just placed down a couple more and just did a bit of detail in this area, so that gives off a little bit more of a mansion-y vibe of this district, which I think also makes sense being so close to the theatre district, which is a slightly nicer district within Springfield. But now we are working in the opposite of that. We are working in East Springfield, which is a bit more of the rundown type of areas. It's not quite as nice as some of the other districts around Springfield. So I wanted to add a little bit more detail around here, finishing up where the monorail line is. I didn't really do a lot of detail around here, and thought, you know, a little bit of a park maybe, and some scattered bushes, and then I thought, okay, well, who could potentially live in East Springfield? Like, who, like, what characters don't really have, who are doing it pretty tough, don't have a lot of money? And I thought, well, Nelson's probably one of them, unfortunately. Like, Nelson's always one of those characters. Like, he's a bully and he's a bit of a mean guy, but I just got a bit of a soft spot for Nelson. I just feel like he's so hard done by, doesn't have a great life, and then he's, you know, just makes him into a bully. So I figured we should probably give him a house. There's a couple of references to Nelson's house, and I tried to use this one house as a way of creating that using procedural objects, and I get pretty damn close. One thing that really helps is I use these benches as the wooden deck, because that's obviously something that I definitely needed to do. So this is what I mean. This is why episodes take so long, because I do stupid stuff like this. But I am quite happy that I did do it, because I think the result's actually quite cool. And I've just even separated them a little bit so that you can see some holes within the deck too. And then the door was in the wrong spot, so I replaced it with this older looking door. And, you know, these are just the reasons why episodes take so long. Because I'm just doing some extra detail that I probably didn't really need to do. But yeah, Nelson's house, there it is. And then I thought, okay, well, who else could potentially live here? And I thought, okay, well, I reckon the crazy cat lady would live here too. So I gave her a house, and I thought that this one was much, much, much easier. Just scattered around some cats, which just so happened to be on the Steam Workshop. There's everything on the Steam Workshop, guys. It's ridiculous. I know this game's 5 years old now, but I just, you know, you can type in cats into the Steam, onto the Workshop, and then all of a sudden, there's a whole bunch of cats on the Workshop. So, I don't know, it's just crazy. Like, I'm just, with this series, I'm noticing the sheer volume of content on the Workshop. And I just do just have to give a shout out to all the content creators, because far out, you guys are the best. We've got some really great stuff. All right, last thing. I was thinking who else could potentially live in East Springfield. And by the way, if you've got some other people who could potentially live around here, like, hit me up in the comments, because I'm sure there's a bunch of other characters who are a little more hard done by, who could potentially live around here. But I thought, I reckon this character could live there, and I'm not going to tell you who it is just yet. Like, I want you to have a bit of a think about who could potentially live in this house that I'm trying to create right now. It's a bit more of a more obscure reference, something that I wasn't going to build this, but I was actually watching The Simpsons just the other day, and this came on, I was like, oh my god, so doing that. But of course, this is Lenny's house, and it's from when Marge was a real estate agent, and poor Lenny.
Please don't tell anyone how I live.
And I thought he should potentially live in East Springfield, and of course I'm doing the version where his wall has collapsed, and he's obviously not sitting there, but you can imagine that it's just happened and he's gone off and caught a repairman. But on that note, but look, that is it. But on that note, it is time to wrap up this episode. Guys, thank you so much for watching. It has been a bit of a random one, so appreciate you watching all the way to the end. Next episode, we'll be working in Bumtown. I know exactly where I'm going to be placing it, and I know how it's going to take shape. And I actually think it's going to be a better location. So we're doing that in the next episode, but it won't be for about 2 weeks or so as we get into Marble Mountain and build some pretty cool stuff. So yeah, we'll be doing that next week. Special shoutouts to the wonderful people supporting the channel: Jim Royster, Marcus Allen, Jordan Darnell, Kenan Coig, Riley Callahan, Maxwell Hayes, Thomas Applin, and John Reed. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!